I got up and prayed and, you know, seeking the Lord as what he wanted me to preach on today. And all of a sudden, I flipped open a paper that I had a couple of weeks back. And I wrote this title down, I don't know, 2 or 3 weeks ago. It kind of dropped in my heart, and I thought it, you know, the Lord wanted me to minister it that week. It was about 2 or 3 weeks ago. But then he didn't. He said, just hold it for a while, you know. So I did. And this morning, when I seen this title, it was like, okay, that's it. Fact or truth, which do we believe?
Amen.
You know, and a lot of people think that facts and truth are the same. But they're not.
Amen.
What does fact mean? Fact is a thing that is indisputably, is a thing that is indisputably the case. Used in discussing the significance of something that is the case. A piece of information used as evidence or as part of a report or news or a news article. So all of that meaning of fact, sounds like fact is truth. And in a lot of times, in our natural world that we walk in, fact can be truth. Not always. Sometimes facts ain't the truth. Amen?
That's right.
Now what is truth? Truth is the quality or state of being true. Truth is the self-expression of God. That is the biblical meaning of truth. Truth is that which is true or in accordance with the fact or reality. True, and I like this, truth is a fact or a belief that is accepted as truth. It can be a fact that's accepted as truth. It can be a belief that is accepted as truth. In other words, what we believe, we accept it as truth. Amen?
Yeah.
Some people don't accept a Christianity as truth. Some people don't expect the Word of God to be truth, but it is.
Yeah.
And that's what I'm bringing out this morning is, this is truth.
Amen.
That's what I want to bring out. This is truth.
Amen.
Jesus said in John 14:6, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. Amen?
Yes, yeah, that's right.
And see, there's a lot of people don't like that because, you know, they say, well, you know, a lot of people want to say that there's lots of ways to get to God. Lots of ways to get to heaven. You know. Not just one God. There's all kind of gods, you know. But Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. So that needs to form a belief in us, and it needs to form a belief that we need to count as truth. Amen?
Yeah.
All right. John chapter 1 and verse 1, it says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Amen? Father, I just praise you this morning, and I thank you that as this Word goes forth, Father, that you will establish it in our hearts.
Yes, Lord.
We give you praise for it, and I thank you, Father, that as your word goes forth, that you will anoint the hearts of the church to hear what the Spirit would say to the church this morning, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right, I want to start over with John chapter 1. I feel like it, the Lord wants me to read a pretty good bit here because what I want to do, I want to establish that this word is truth and this word is Jesus. You You know, we heard Pastor Katie. Pastor Katie was preaching last week, and she was expounding on that whenever she wants to hug Jesus, she just takes her Bible and she hugs him like that, and she's hugging Jesus, you know, because that's the Word.
Amen.
And the Word is Jesus. And that's what we're going to establish this morning. Amen?
Yeah.
That the Word is Jesus. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word is with a big W. I need to get over to John. I'm reading it off my notes here. Because I don't have it all wrote down on there. In the beginning was the Word with a big W.
Yeah.
See, whenever the Word is capitalized, like the word God, you always capitalize the letter God if you're talking about Elohim, if you're talking about God Almighty. Now, whenever you're talking about the gods of the Hindus, it's with a little G, you know. So anytime you're referencing God as God Almighty, it's with a big G. Or Jesus, it's with a big J. It's
yeah.
with a capital J. Amen? Or Jehovah. Lord God Jehovah. It's with a big L and a big J. Amen?
Amen.
That sets apart Him as God, holy, the Almighty. Amen? So, in the beginning was the Word with a big W, and the Word with a big W was with God, big G, and the Word, big W, was God, and He, with a big H, was with God in the beginning.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, the Word in God was in the beginning.
Yes.
And they were together. Through Him all things were made. Without Him nothing was made that has been made. In Him was life, and that life was the light of man. Now Jesus said in John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Amen?
Yeah.
In Him was the life. He said, I am the life. And that life was the light of man. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. There came a man who was sent from God. His name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning the light. The light is Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
So that through Him all men might believe. He Himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through Him or made by Him, the world did not recognize Him. He came to that which was His own, but His own did not recognize Him. Yet to all who received Him, to those who believed in His name, He gave the right to become children of God.
Amen.
See, when we get saved, when we believe on Jesus, when we accept Him as Lord and Savior, that's when He gives us the right to become a child of God. He makes us righteous in God's sight. He restores our relationship to Him.
Amen.
He restores our sonship. That's what I'm trying to say. He restores our sonship to Him. Amen?
Amen.
He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who received him, to those who believe in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human descent, or a husband's will, but born of God.
Amen.
The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. Amen?
Yes.
I mean, that right there explains who was in the beginning to me.
Yeah.
You know, but that's what I want us to see, that this Word is Jesus.
Yeah.
Yes.
This Word is Jesus, and Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no man comes to the Father but by me. So we need to establish that this Word is truth.
Yes.
Yes.
Because you see, what I'm trying to get you to see is facts and truth are different.
Yeah.
And facts will say one thing, and truth will say something else.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. Who is the Word? The Word is Jesus. The Word is Jesus. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Now, if Jesus is the Word and Jesus is the truth, so if Jesus is the Word and the truth, then the Word must be true.
Yes.
Because Jesus is the Word and the Word is the truth, is Jesus, then the Word must be truth. This Word.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
So fact and truth is not the same thing. Amen?
Yeah.
Fact says, I'm sick. My nose is running. Man, my nose is running. I can't, You know, that's a fact. I mean, you can see it. You can tell it's running. You can't get it under control. You know, you're sick. Amen? So your nose is running. So that's a fact. But what does truth say about that? Truth says in 1 Peter 2:24, truth says in Isaiah 4 and 5, that by his stripes I am healed. That's
yep.
what truth says.
Amen.
Amen. Let's look at 1 Peter 2:24. So, you know, yeah, I'm not just saying it. Let's look at it in the Word. 1 Peter 2:24. It says, 1 Peter 2:24. He himself bore our sins in his body on the tree so that we might die to sin and live for righteousness. By his wounds, you have been healed.
Amen.
Amen.
That's looking back at the cross. That's looking back. See, when Jesus died on the cross, his body was broken for our healing. He took every sickness that's known to man, he took it on himself that day. He bore it that day. Let's go to Isaiah. It's back in the Old Testament. It's right after Psalms and Proverbs. Isaiah 53. I'm going to start reading in verse 1. I tell you what, I'm going to start reading back up at verse 13 of 52, and then I'll go into verse 53. I just feel like I need to read this Word because that's what I want to establish, is this Word is the truth. This Word is Jesus. And this is talking about Jesus here. It says, and starting in verse 13 of verse 52, it says, "See, my servant will act wisely. He will be raised and lifted up and highly exalted. Just as there were many who were appalled at him, his appearance was so disfigured beyond that of any man, and his form mired beyond human likeness." That's talking about whenever he was on the cross and he was beaten, and he took all the sins and the sickness and disease of man upon him. So will he spankle many nations, and kings will shut their mouths because of him. For what they were not told, they will see. And what they have not heard, they will understand. Who has believed our message, and whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? He grew up before him like a tender shoot, and like a root out of dry ground. He had no beauty or majesty to attract us to him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrow and familiar with suffering, like one from whom men hid their face. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Now this is the scriptures right here that's going to speak of our healing. Surely he took our infirmities, our sicknesses, our diseases, he took them on himself.
Yes.
Amen. He took it. You see. He bore it for us. So when we're bearing things like that now, we're bearing something that he's already bore for us.
Amen.
Amen. He's already bore it. So why should we carry it anymore?
That's right.
He's already carried it. Surely he took our infirmities and carried our sorrows. Yet we considered him stricken by God, smitten by him, and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him. And by his wounds, we are healed.
Amen.
This is truth, folks. This is truth here.
Yeah.
Facts and truth are not the same. Fact says my bank account is empty. Truth says in Philippians 4:19 that my God shall supply all of my needs according to his riches in glory.
Yes. Amen.
Fact will say I am weak. Truth says I am strong in the Lord and in the power of his mighty, of his might. That's Ephesians 6:10. Truth, a fact or belief that is accepted as truth. Amen?
Yeah.
It's a belief that we accept as truth.
Yeah.
You've got to believe and accept that this word is truth. If you don't, you're going to walk in darkness.
Yeah.
A lot of people won't accept this word as truth.
Yeah.
And when they don't accept it as truth, they walk in darkness.
Yeah. Amen.
That's right.
Just all there is to it. Because we come here. We are born into darkness. When we're born into darkness.
Yeah.
But then the light comes on, and it's up to us to accept that light. Who
Amen.
Is the light? Jesus is the light.
Amen.
Amen. Truth will change fact.
Yes, it will.
But
Amen.
Fact will not change truth.
That's right. Amen.
It's the truth that you believe will change the fact.
Yes.
Amen. Like I said, fact will say my nose is running, but the truth of God's word says by his stripes I've been healed. fact says my bank account is empty, but the truth says that, that he shall supply all of my needs according to his riches in glory.
Yeah.
Amen? Fact says there's nothing there. Fact says there's nothing there. Fact says there's nothing there. But what does the truth say? The truth says that the Holy Spirit is with us always. He
yeah.
never leaves us nor forsakes us. He's here with us.
Amen.
That's what the truth says. See, the fact says there's nothing here. But the truth says the Holy Spirit is here.
Yeah.
You see? And so with our natural eyes, we will say there's nothing here. But the truth is Holy Spirit here. Truth is there's angels all around here.
Yes.
You see? There's angels all around us. It's like Elijah and his servant were surrounded by, what was that king's name? Anyway. And Elijah, the servant, went out looking. He said, "Oh, master," he said, "they're all over the place around us. What are we going to do?" And there was just two of them there, him and Elijah. And Elijah said, "Oh, that's okay. There's more for us than there is
yeah.
for them." And the servant looks at Elijah and he says, "Well, wait a minute now. There's just me and you." And God said, "Open his eyes." Elijah said, "Open his eyes, Lord." And so God opened Elijah's eyes, opened the servant's eyes, and he seen angels all around.
Yeah.
Don't you know he got excited? Whenever his eyes were open, see, it wasn't these eyes that were opened up.
That's right.
It was his spiritual eyes. Amen?
Amen.
It was his spiritual eyes were open. And he began to see into the spirit. He seen the spiritual realm. And he seen those angels. Amen?
Amen.
Truth says Holy Spirit's here. Truth says angels are all around us. Fact is what we see. Fact is what we feel. Fact is what we smell. Fact is what we hear. And fact is what we taste. But truth says we walk by faith and not by sight.
Right.
We walk by faith and not by what we feel. We walk by faith and not by what we smell.
Right.
We walk by faith and not by what we hear.
Yeah.
We walk by faith and not by what we taste. Our five senses. We walk by faith and not by what we see. And not by sight. That covers all five of our senses. Amen?
Yeah.
And truth says that by his stripes we've been healed. Truth says that he supplies all my needs according to his riches
yeah.
and glory. Amen?
Yeah.
Truth says there's only one way to the Father, and that's through Jesus.
Yeah.
That's what truth says. And truth is what we've established that we believe.
Yeah.
And this is truth, and we believe it is truth. If you don't believe it is truth, like I said, you're in darkness.
Yeah.
Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the Word. And the Word is the truth. And the Word is truth. So Jesus is truth.
Yeah.
And Jesus is the truth. Amen. We need to find out what, we need to find the Word, we need to find out what the Word says about something, and you will find out the truth about what that something is.
Yeah.
That don't make a bit of sense, does it, the way I said it?
Gotcha.
You know, if we are if we are sick and we're believing God for healing, then we need to go to the words, we need to find out words in here. I just gave you some this morning that we can stand on.
Yeah.
You see? Yeah, fact says we're sick, but the word says by his stripes we're healed.
Yeah.
So we go to that word and we choose to believe this word and we continue to believe in, and I say it, truth will change facts.
Yes.
But fact will not change truth.
That's right.
Yes. So if you have some facts in your life that you won't change, then you need to start believing the truth.
Yeah.
And the truth will change those facts.
That's it. That's it.
Are you hearing me?
Amen.
I've seen it happen.
Yes. Yep.
See, the devil is a liar.
Yeah.
Yes.
And the devil comes with lies and tries to deceive us.
Yeah.
But the truth says, by his stripes we're healed. The truth says he meets all my needs according to his riches and glory.
Yeah.
Donna, does he meet your needs according to his riches and glory?
Yes, he does.
For 20-something years, he's met your needs, hasn't he?
Yes.
I mean, her and her husband divorced. She was raising two boys. God's given her, what, three vehicles?
Three vehicles.
I mean, he has just took care of her those whole 20 years. She's never been in need.
Praise God.
No. See, because God's word says in Psalms 23 that the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not be in want.
That's right.
He's our shepherd. You know, like you could say it like this. A little kid would say, he's my daddy and I will never want for anything because he's my daddy. You know, my kids growing up, they never wanted for nothing. You know, and we went through some hard times, but they never knew it. You know, if you would have asked them, they were some of the richest kids on the corner. And we was broke as a billy goat in the Sahara Desert. We was. Amen. You know, but the truth of God's word says he supplies our needs. And you know, and back then, you know, we was just getting into learning to believe God for things, you know. So we had to learn all this, you know. And we just kept believing, you know, and there was facts out there, you know. I mean, time and time again, Katie has looked at the checkbook, and the end of the month was way bigger than the end of the money. The end of the month come, and the money's gone, and the month's still big on us, you know. And we, you know, we just kept believing and kept struggling and kept believing, and now, you know,
it always works.
Yeah, it does. And now the end of our money is bigger than the end of the month.
Praise
now, you got to make some adjustments sometimes, and you got to make some wise decisions, you know, and you got to learn sometimes that what you're doing, you got to change and do something different, you know.
Amen.
I mean, it's the same way with finances, it's the same way with sickness.
Yeah.
You know, there may be some things that the reason you're sick is because of some things you're doing that you getting well and then you getting right back sick, you know. You know, take like a runny nose. Our youngest son, he didn't believe in sickness. He kept a runny nose always, but he went around barefooted. He wouldn't wear a shirt. But he never was sick. But he never got over the runny nose, did he? But what I'm saying is, you know, if you want to get well, sometimes what you need to do is find out what's causing that sickness and quit doing that and start believing God to heal you.
Yeah.
You know, you may need to change some things.
Amen.
You know, such as finances, a lot of times people say, you know, well, I can't get ahead. But you keep throwing your money in a sock with holes in it. You keep throwing it into something other that you ought not be throwing it in. You know, you keep, you know, maybe you can take like people that go out and eat all the time, and when they can save a lot of money if they just stay home and eat some good food, eat some rice and gravy and turnip greens and stuff like that, you know. But instead, every night they're going out and buying pizza, you know.
Yep.
When you stop and you begin to think, where's my money going? If you go to looking at it, well, golly, man, we're spending $1,000 a month on this. No wonder we can't meet our $500 car note. We throwing $1,000 a month out on pizza.
Come on.
I know I'm hitting home with somebody, but hey, it's the truth.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Yep.
You know, we had to change some things. We had to learn. We had to learn, man. You know, some things you kids can't do anymore. Right. You know, that's like Katie told our daughter yesterday. Because now they got four kids.